Hey, good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone. How are you guys doing today? Hey, this is Gregory Wiles coming live to you from Houston, Texas with this inspirational morning talk, man. For first-time listeners, I'm on Thursdays, but I have an apology, man. Yesterday, I did not make it on. I work all through the night to come in. I was so tired. I could not represent God properly. Come on, life, to do anything. I need to be at my best to represent him properly. He requires our best of us. So I just decided to do it today. We're in a much better shape, feeling better, get some rest so I can represent him properly, man. So my apologies for the people who was looking out for the message yesterday, but I can make it up. I can do it today. Good morning, Tessa. Good morning, cuz. How are you doing today? How are you doing today? Yes, I'll make it up today, man. I can make it up today because this is my service. This is my service. This is what I give back. And I'm serious about it. All right? And that's what I want to talk about today. The message you lead me to give today is about our willingness to give. Our willingness to give and the motive behind our giving and all of that, right? The willingness to give. So if you feel threat, right? We should not allow threats or flattery to motivate our giving. We should not allow any threats. Patricia Blackmon, good morning. How are you doing? So we should not allow any threats or flattery to motivate our giving, as this is not the leading of the Holy Spirit. So if you feel threatened to give, if you feel pressured, if somebody guilting you into giving, said, no, you should not do that. That is not the leading of the Holy Spirit. As soon as you feel under pressure to give, we must stop immediately. If you feel under pressure to give, you must stop immediately. This is not the correct motivation for giving. And the motivation of and forgiving is the most critical issue. Our motivation for giving is the most critical issue. So God does not consider the amount that you give. He looks at the motive behind the giving. Not the amount, but the motive behind the giving. So we just got to be careful. We can look at two scriptures, what he's saying. So once you're feeling pressured or guilt, people guilting you into giving or pressure, no, it must come freely. It must come joyfully. It must come from your heart. You're going to get the joy of giving it. You don't want it to be given reluctantly, as the scriptures say here. As the scriptures say here in 2 Corinthians 8:12, when Paul was talking to the Corinthians, they were doing a good job of giving and all of that, and they kind of stopped, and he was just kind of encouraging them on. And he's saying in 2 Corinthians 8:12, he said, "For if the willingness is there, the gift is acceptable according to what one has, not according to what one does not have." He said the willingness is there. If the willingness, you got to be willing to give it, then the gift is accepted according to what you have, not what you don't have. You can't give what you don't have, right? You give what you do have. And that's why God said, I don't consider the amount. It's your motive, right? It's your motive. And that's what 2 Corinthians, he went out for it in 2 Corinthians 9:6-9, and he's saying, remember, whoever sows sparingly will reap sparingly. This is why he don't care the amount what you give, whether it's your time, your money, your resources, just like what I'm doing here. I just come down and I give in of the gifts that he gives me, and I'm sharing. He's saying it's the motive behind it. He don't consider how much, but he's saying, because he said, I got a law there already. I got my law. If you sow sparingly, you'll reap sparingly. So it's up to you. It's up to you. This is not up to me, and I ain't going to tell you what's up to you, right? He said, just remember, Paul was telling him, who sows sparingly will reap sparingly, and who sows generously will reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your hearts, not reluctantly or under compulsion, or some transitions under pressure, for God loves a cheerful giver. He wants you to do it cheerfully. He said, I don't care about the amount that you're giving, but do it cheerfully. Do it from your heart. You decide in your heart how much you give. So don't let anyone pressure you. Don't let pressure. Once you're feeling this pressure and guilt, it's not the Holy Spirit leading you to do it. So you just stop. You just stop right there. When you give in, it must be freely. It must be from your heart. You must get a joy to do it, right? He said, God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all you need, you will abound in good works. He said, when the motive behind your giving is free and it's coming from your heart, whatever you decide to give your heart. He done got his ruling. He said, if you sow sparingly, you can reap sparingly, you sow abundantly, you reap abundantly. That's your decision how you want to reap, right? According to how you sow. But he loves a cheerful giver. He loves when you do it cheerfully. He loves when you do it not grudgingly. He loves when you do it freely from your heart. That's what he's saying here, right? So I want to tell people, your willingness to give is what counts. Now, the amount is your willingness. And you got to give from what you have and not what you don't have, right? He knows what you have. He knows what you don't have. But you can't give from what you don't have. You give from what you have. And that don't have to be money. You can give your time. You can give resources. You can give so much of different things that you can give. But whatever you decide to give, make sure it's coming from the heart and it's not under no pressure and you doing it off of your own free will. Because then, for the willingness, 2 Corinthians 8:12, if the willingness is there, the gift is acceptable according to what one has and what don't have. So that's how your gifts and your giving is going to be acceptable and pleasing to him. And that's when you're going to get this, and he's able to bless you abundantly and all of that. But because he looked at the motives, he looked at the motive. Okay, why are you doing this? Right? Why are you doing this? You're doing this because you really want to do it, or somebody pressure you or guilt you into doing it. You're not gonna get your reward like that. You can get your reward when it's freely coming from your heart because you see a need and you just want to help. Good morning, Jillian. Good morning. Right? So that's what this is saying. So I'm gonna just recap quickly. You know, we're talking about willingness to give, right? We should not allow threats or flattery to motivate our giving. And this is not the leading of the Holy Spirit. As soon as you feel under pressure to give, we must stop immediately. This is not the Holy Spirit leading us when we feel pressure or under pressure or be guilt, right? This is not the correct motivation for giving. And it's the motivation for giving that is most, that is the most critical issue. God does not consider the amount given. He looks at the motive behind the giving. And let me recap these two scriptures quickly and we can close it out here. 2 Corinthians 8:12 saying, for if the willingness is there, the gift is acceptable according to what one has, not according to what one does not have. And 2 Corinthians 9, read from 6 through 9, it said, remember, this, whoever sows sparingly will reap sparingly, and who sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in good in every good work, as it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever, guys. So guys, I just want to leave that with you. Whatever you give in, make sure it's freely coming from your heart, and don't let anyone force you to give. Don't give under pressure. Don't let anyone guilt you into giving. Just make sure it's coming from your heart when you give it. You're freely giving it. Right, and that's when he that's accepted by God. Okay, this person freely gave this. This comes from their heart. They want to do this, not because they had to do it, but because they want to do it. Right, and that's the difference in giving. You must want to do it, and don't feel you have to do it. Right. So, guys, I'm gonna leave that there, guys. But you guys have a great weekend. And you know what? I may come on and do something over the weekend to make up for missing yesterday. All right, so have a great day. Okay, bye.